this house in Hudson. By the way, I promised my wife if I wasn't going to tell the story, I cannot say the address or the amount of money that we paid for the house. So I'm going to try here, okay? So we'll call it Schmenkel Drive in Rumson, New Jersey. She says, you may want to check this out. I go, oh, geez, no, I know Schmenkel Drive. It's a lot of money. I don't want it. He said, no. Here's the opening bid, and you really want to look at this. Just Google it. So I Googled it. And it shows up, now normally I deal with very small potatoes, very small houses. This was, if I can carry on the vegetable metaphor, this was a big yam. This was huge.
Oh my God.
Like nothing I've ever done before. And when I Googled it, it was an even bigger yam than what the sheriff department was auctioning it off for. So I tell my wife, listen, I'm just gonna go there, look around the windows. And I took a video with my wife and I sent it to her and she's like, holy crap. Literally, it's on an acre and a half, it's enormous, it's on a pond. I'm like, oh my God, it's a nice house, right? By the way, you're in this monologue in a second. I go, and I said, what the hell? I just sold a few houses, so I had some money in the bank. I'm like, look, you live once, so you have to pull out 20%. So I pull out 20%, I go, and I'm literally shaking as I head to the auction. Mind you, I got this message at 11 o'clock in the morning and I have to buy the house by 2 o'clock in the afternoon.
Holy shit.
So I have my cashier's checks, the whole bit, and I'm off to Freehold, New Jersey. Now normally when these auctions go, people leave as houses are sold. And it was the last one of the day and nobody left. So here it comes. Ladies and gentlemen, next house up. Schmenkel Drive in Rumson, New Jersey, 1.1 million. I go, 1.1 million. There's a pause going once, twice, so, 1.1 million. I go, Jesus Christ! What is wrong with this? And I start screaming at the other investors that are in the room that I've known for years. I go, what is wrong with this that none of you bid against me? This is somebody yelled out, it's in a flood zone, and another person yelled out it was wrecked and sandy. I go, no, that's a pond. That's not the Shrewsbury River. That's a pond. And then I thought to myself, oh my God, maybe they don't know. So I pay my money, and I drive to Rumson, New Jersey. Now, mind you, you're not supposed to do what I just did. Or I'm about to do.
Oh my God.
I took out a drill, and I drilled a lockout.
Oh my God. Are you? Thank God. It's special.
And I opened the door. Now, I gotta tell you,
God.
Every investor does this, but they don't tell you that. So I open up the door. The alarm goes off. So I shut the door. Oh my God, the cops are coming. So I run up on Schmenkel Drive in Rumson, New Jersey, and I wait for the police.
How'd you feel street?
Oh my God, I hope he recognizes me. Maybe I got an edge there. I'm screwed. So the police officer pulls up, rolls down the window. He looks at me and goes, Brian Kirk? I go, yeah. He goes, yeah, dude, you seem off key. You're terrible.
Oh my God.
He goes, what are you doing here? I go, I just bought this house in foreclosure and I opened the door. The door was open, I lied to him. The door was open and the alarm went off and I figured I'd wait for you. He goes, well, you did the right thing. I gotta shut the alarm off anyway. Let's go see what you bought.
Oh.
I'm like, oh my God. So a police officer is escorting me through the house that I just bought, and I'm seeing the inside for the first time. My wife shows up around this time, and we're both looking at each other as we go around every part of the house. I'm like, oh my God, they cleaned it before. It's just unbelievable. We start hugging each other, and I'm thinking I hit the lottery. I'm like, oh my God, this is the best. So it was great. Now, the police officer gets a phone call. He's like, Brian, it's the station. Hang on a second. It's like, Miami? No. Brian Kirk, you know that singer guy? He bought the house. What? Huh? He puts out the phone. He goes, Brian, do you have the deed? I go, oh, no. I only put down 20%. I get the deed after 30 days when I pay off the rest of it, which I'm not sure how I'm going to pay it off. I get the deed then. He goes, yeah, the owners are in Miami and they're watching us on video right now. In the
Oh my god.
They're taking you through the house. I'm like, he's like, you shouldn't have told me.
He's special.
That you bought the house. I go, yeah, I kind of did, you know, and I really didn't try to deceive him, but I should have told him I only put 20% down. I don't actually own the house yet. So he's like, fine, we gotta get out of here. He locks the door. He says, you're not getting back for 30 days. You get the deed and get back in here. I'm not trying to argue with him. He said, Brian, no. So now, at this point, I'm just glad I'm not under arrest. And I'm freaking out on how I'm going to afford the house. That's where this man comes in who just sat down. So I get approved for the loan, blah, 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 blah. The bank tells me I can't give you a loan based on the receipt that I have in the HUD statement, blah, blah. I said, what am I going to do? He said, well, you can get somebody to buy you now and give you that money, and then we'll pay it back. I'm like, who am I going to get to do that? And then I thought, there's a guy who's here, his name is Joe, and up until 35 years ago, side note to the story, true story, 35 years ago, for 35 years, he was a used car salesman. Then 5 years ago, he won $90 million in the Powerball. And he's sitting right here in the front row. Sorry, Joe. Fighting me late to the show. So I call Joe up. And I go, Joe, I bought this house in Austin, and I need $1 million. For about 3 months, an hour, and that works. Joe paused for 5 seconds and goes, come pick up the check. I'm like, what? I call up my wife, we're hugging each other. You're the effing man. Oh wait, man, thank you. This man just changed my life and my wife's life. And my family's life. So now, it's 45 days later, and we're moving to Rumson, New Jersey. I'm like, this is awesome. Except, I've only been in the house for 10 minutes. I don't know if there's termite damage, mold, whatever. So, I have no choice. I call